In this video, we're going to talk about the procedure for the testing the condenser fan motor. Now, at this point, you've already tested your thermostat, you've tested your air handler, you've tested the power to the condenser, and we've covered that in other videos, but we now want us to pay specific attention to the condenser fan motor. Now, even if the condenser fan motor is 100% running, okay, it is still worth doing some of these electrical tests and walking through this procedure. If you follow this on a running condenser fan motor, it's very likely that you might find that the motor's going to go bad in the next 6 months or 4 weeks or whatever, and you can save your customer and your company a return service call. So to test the condenser fan motor properly, what we want to do is we want to disconnect the condenser motor from L1, L2, and the capacitor. Okay, if you do that as your first step, you're never going to forget to do it as you continue on through the testing. So next, check if the condenser fan spins freely. Now, part of the reason why I want you to disconnect this before you test the spinning of the motor is this way you never have a chance of accidentally energizing that motor while your fingers are in it. If the condenser fan does not spin freely, just replace the motor. Okay, most of these are now sealed bearings. Putting oil on it doesn't help. And condenser fans have to spin freely or you don't get enough airflow and proper airflow across that coil. Also, if a condenser fan motor is not spinning freely, as it heats up, it's just going to get worse. Okay, so it's very likely the thing could be working properly while you're sitting in front of it. Pressures look good and everything. But 3 hours after you leave, you're going to suddenly have a very upset customer because that condenser fan motor is heated up and stopped working. Okay, if the condenser fan motor does spin freely, check for resistances between R and C, that's run in common, S and C, start in common, and R to S. What you're looking for in these is some numbers, okay? You do not want a zero, and you do not want your meter to show infinite or OL. Okay, zero and OL are bad readings for resistances across windings. A zero means that winding is shorted. OL means the winding is open. So check it for the resistance. Okay, if R to C has a number, S to C has a number, then R to S should be the sum of both the other numbers, and you want to check it. Okay, your R to S reading should be the R to C and the C to S added together or very close to it. Okay, if any of these readings are bad, replace the condenser fan motor. Okay, the next thing you want to do is take a reading from each of these from the three wires R, C, and S to ground. Okay, frame ground, the motor frame itself. Okay, put one lead of your meter on the frame and one lead of the meter on the whichever winding you're testing. Okay, if any of these windings have a path to ground over like or under like 1.2 mega ohms or 1 mega ohm, depending on what you're using, that motor shorted to ground. It's going to fail. It's going to start blowing breakers if it hasn't already. Just replace the motor. Okay, if everything else tests out good on the motor windings, okay, go ahead and remove the leads from the capacitor and test the capacitor. Now, as you're removing leads, make sure you know where they go, okay? One of the best ways to do this, take a picture with your cell phone so you always get the leads back in the correct place. Or look at the schematic and make sure it's wired properly to start with. So remove the leads from the capacitor and test the capacitor. Realize that a lot of these capacitors are combo capacitors. You're going to have some leads going to the compressor and you're going to have some leads going to the fan. You have to remove both start leads or you're going to have a problem because you'll have two capacitors in parallel with each other. So again, is the fan capacitor good? Okay, if it's within 10%, okay, of your rating, or sometimes 5%, depending on what the tolerance is on the capacitor, okay, it's good. If it's outside of that, it's not good. Replace the fan capacitor. If you replace the fan motor through your resistance tests, you're automatically going to replace the fan capacitor. Do not ever install a new motor with an old capacitor. Okay, it's part of a replacing a motor. Replace that capacitor. Okay, if everything tests out on the fan, you're going to reconnect the condenser fan motor and you're going to test it. Does it run? Okay, if it doesn't run, okay, you have to go back and test it again. Okay, if you have power to this motor, which we've already established in the condenser tests, if you have power to that contactor and that condenser fan does not run, okay, you've missed a step in here, okay? Because if you've done all of this and you have power to the motor, which we've tested with the condenser diagnostics, that fan should run. So again, we would jump back and continue on with our condenser diagnostics. But it's a real easy, if you do it the same way every time, disconnect motor, check for bearings, check the resistances of windings, check resistance to ground, check the fan capacitor, you're going to do it the same way every time. You'll never miss a step.